second thing then we will talk about is Google Docs. So in the Google Drives, you can see when I click some new here. So you can see there are four options: Google Docs, Sheets, Slides, Forms, and many more. Okay, so I will talk about these particular four. So whenever we are organizing webinars, we are organizing online classes, these softwares are very much required, because on normal Excel softwares, normal Microsoft Office software, we cannot work remotely. However, nowadays Microsoft has also launched what is called on OneDrive. So when you go to OneDrive, you can see similar option there. They have online version of, I have to sign in there. So they have online version of Microsoft Office, Microsoft PowerPoint, Excel, etc. So just let me just tell you, this is a Microsoft OneDrive, and I am opening a Excel workbook here. This is similar to the Google Sheets, but it's very much easier to use rather than Google Sheet, because we are much familiar with the interface of Office. So you can also use that. Let me go to Google Doc. So this is Google Doc here. So I have already created so many files. So the main utility of the Google Doc is you can write any essay, application, letter, whatever, you any information, and you can share this among your colleagues. Like, just let me open this one. So this is some file that was created to in the organization, NITG organization, when we organized this AHEP 2020. So this is there is lot of data that we manage simultaneously remotely, and the main thing was this share button. Okay, so this is shared almost with 10-12 people, and the power of this software is the 10 people can simultaneously edit this document, and for every addition the backup is saved. Let's say by mistake someone has deleted the data, but you can still retrieve. How you can do that? You can go to this see new changes, and you can see what changes are made by different person in the group. So the all information is stored in this Google Doc. Moreover, you can also see the different versions, like on Tuesday, September 22, who edited and what addition they make. Okay, like on September 22, the document was something like this. On 3/11, the document was something like this. And 4/50, the document something like this. So if you want to retrieve the previous document, you just go to that version, check whether you want the same document, and you hit the restore version. Okay, so you can get rid of the you should not worry about the data handling. It saves automatically. Similarly, there are lots of options there, so I will just highlight some main options. So you are familiar with the Microsoft Word interface. Now the main thing is you can also open any Microsoft Doc from your computer. You just upload, and you can upload this any doc file if I have any. So we can upload and edit this file. Okay, this you know, I'm not going to talk about much. I'm just canceling it. Similarly, if I want to download this present file, so it will give me many options, like whether I want to download in docx format, rich format, pdf document, etc., etc. Also, there is a version history. As I told you previously, there are so many versions created by different shared participants. We can retrieve the particular version and publish to the web, which I find very fascinating. Why? So when I hit this publish to the web, so it asks me two options, link, embed. When I hit embed, it asks me for script or HTML kind of thing. So let's forget about that. So when I ask link, it will ask me, are you sure you want to publish this selection? Yes, I am sure. So it will give me this link. And if I open the same link in the incognito mode, so I can see the doc here. So this is not editable. So you can share the information with anyone. You can also create your website and embed it in your website. And the main power is you need not to share this doc, share the link or change the link again and again. If you edit this document here, it will automatically get changed on this site. It will be updated in every 5 minutes. So it is very useful when we are doing the changes on the backend, and if someone knows how websites work, how backends are managed, then it is very, very useful for that purpose. So I will just give you some example about this. So this website is the Google site of AHEP, and this is the backend where we manage and design all the things. Now in this tab schedule, you can see I have embedded this Google Doc. Okay, this is not a picture, but it is a Google Doc which is somewhere in this folder. I have linked there too. And if I change the Google Doc here, let me tell you, my internet is not very good. So if I change the doc here, it will automatically get updated here. So this is the power of Google Doc, and it can be embedded in HTML as HTML code as well. Similar work can be done for Google Sites. Google Sheets and Google Slides. So for the time being, let's stick to the Google Docs. So there we talk about the publish to the web. So completed that. So these format you are very familiar. Okay, we are used to Microsoft Word. So this is same more or less. So there is nothing more special to discuss in the Google Docs. And there are some other options, like these are calendar, keep, and tasks that we will discuss later. Similarly, if I talk about Google Sheets are also similar, and it is you can say online version of Microsoft Excel. Everything is similar. The usage of publish to the web, download, open, everything is similar. So So I will talk about few add-on. This add-on I have inserted here. So I will talk about the use of this particular thing in the later videos. But right now there is nothing to discuss in this Google Sheet. As well as I just want you to know that Google Sheet is the online version of you can say Microsoft Excel or Excel sheets, numbers in Apple, and similarly Google Slides are the online version of Microsoft PowerPoint. So saying like this is not a good idea, because Microsoft has its own online version, but Google applications are easy to use. I don't know why, but it is very easy to use, at least for me. So these are the Google Slides, and it works as a, in the same manner as was Excel or Docs. Okay, so these are similar things. So I will just skip that, and you can try